Are there people that, I mean, for example, Mel Gibson famously was a guest voice. Would you be comfortable with Mel these days? I mean, if you hadn't used him before, and you, I mean, would you be comfortable using him at this point?
I wrote the Michael Jackson episodes. It's a tough question.
That was a season opener, and we had Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson was a fan of the show and wanted to do it. And it wasn't like your typical, like, Michael Jackson, you know, where he shows up and does the show for the charity or at the school, the fifth grade concert or whatever. They really figured a great way of having him on the show. So we had a big, like, 300-pound white guy who thinks he's Michael Jackson, and Homer meets him, and Homer gets committed because he wore a pink shirt to work. It was such an odd show, and the story was great because even though he was this crazy guy who thought he was Michael Jackson, he actually helped Bart write a song that for Lisa's birthday. So it really was a great, I mean, it had warmth, it was absurd, it was it hit on every level.
And he didn't take a screen credit for some reason. He's John Joseph Smith or something like that.
John J. Smith. I wasn't sure if there was something about whether he had a recording contract that then he couldn't say. I don't know. I really don't.
There were a couple of years there where it was sort of in fashion not to bill yourself as who you were. No?
Well, originally, people thought, it'd be, I don't know whether it was slumming to do a cartoon or kind of an in-joke to just do it but not use your name. And then Jim said after Michael Jackson, that's it. If people want to do the show, we got to use their name. Because it was so hard to publicize it without saying it was him. We were in this awful position. Not awful, but it was just weird.
Joke.
Yeah. Was that really Michael? Can we find out?
legally, I can't say. There's some stars that are so big, you just can't say or not it's them. You'll have to guess. Read between the lines.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's kidding. Yeah.
He did his voice as Michael Jackson on the show, the 300-pound white crazy man, but he did not do the singing. I think there was a conflict with a record studio, with a label that was representing him. So he couldn't do the singing, but he brought in a guy named Kip Lennon.
When I was working for The Simpsons, I had already done a few things for them when they called and said that Michael Jackson was recommending me. And it was as funny to them as it was to me because they already knew me. We were all friends. I'd already worked on the show. And suddenly they said, Michael Jackson says he wants you to do him on for this episode of The Simpsons.
A lot of the times the schedules don't allow us to be there when the guest stars are there, but that was one of the most memorable in terms of being there with the guest star.
Normally we have read-throughs of our script at the 20th Century Fox lot. We went to his manager's house.
He had to go to his manager's house.
Had to go to his manager's house in the evening, precisely 7:30. Michael is ushered in. We're all supposed to be there at 7:30.
I remember he wore a fedora, and he wore his high water pants and his white socks. And he was very, very soft-spoken. He was very, very quiet. Very polite, very respectful.
Just him by himself with a glove and a hat. And, you know, it was literally like Thomas Jefferson walking into the room or Mickey Mouse or something, you know. It was
just wow.
Like, he was so iconic that, you know, because he was right at the peak of his Michael Jacksonness, you know. And, you know, nobody was allowed to have any cameras there, no filming, no autographs, nothing like that. And by the time he arrived, we were all sitting at the table ready to go.
And we're all there except Dan Castellaneta. Dan Castellaneta is, for some reason, maybe the traffic was bad or...
He got lost.
I got mixed up about the time. I thought I had more time. And I was in Hollywood, sitting with a friend, and, you know, and I'm trying to kill time because I go, I'll just go early. Because I was afraid to go there early and nobody would be there. But I said, I'm just going to go early because I can't kill any more time. Well, it turned out I was a half hour late.
So we wait for a long time for Dan. And normally in that situation, conversation would break out, and, you know, as people do when they're waiting for somebody. But Michael was just such an uncomfortable presence that it's the longest silence I've ever experienced in show business as we sat and waited for Dan.
And I walk in there, and I made a joke. I said, I'm sorry, I'm late. It's a good thing I decided to show up early. And we did the thing, and they told me later that Michael Jackson had timed it so that he could sit down at the table and read, because he didn't want to sit and talk with other people. He's that shy. So he sat down at the specific time, and I wasn't there. And they said, there's a whole half hour, nobody said anything. It was, like, really quiet. And everybody was mad at me because they had, because it was, like, a half hour of this discomfort at the table.
It was almost as if parts of his face couldn't move, you know?
Did you try to? Did you say, hey, quite a game the other night at the...
I didn't personally, no. I thought it was not my place. Then...
We're taking a break before the actual recording, and people are eating bagels and playing ping pong, and, you know, and he's just standing in the corner, almost like, you know, he's so painfully shy that it almost seems like nobody could be that shy. But I went over and I introduced myself finally, and I knew everybody in his band, all of his singers and stuff, and I'd already done him on so many projects, so I figured he'd kind of be comfortable.
No.
So kind of small talked a little bit. He was very warm. He was very nice. You'd never say he was a jerk. So it seemed like that's almost like his safety system is to just sort of wall up around himself, you know.
That's Thursday night. Now it's Monday, and we're at Fox recording the show, and Michael is there with us. And in those days, we did an additional read-through before we started recording.
So, and it wasn't very well lit. It wasn't, you know, set up for that. We were just sort of the interlopers for 10 years or whatever. So you have a little light on your music stand. We still have them. And he turned his off. And I remember thinking, how can you see that? How can you see? Like, how can you see?
So he's doing the lines of dialogue, but at some point the character breaks into a song, singing special lyrics to the old Michael Jackson song, Ben. And at that point, Michael sits back and gives sort of a little, almost imperceptible nod of his head, and across the table, a white guy starts singing.
To sing like Michael Jackson, in front of Michael Jackson, for this record. And he's at that time, you know, quite young, small white man who named Kip. Can you imagine the pressure, the anxiety of being in the room with Michael Jackson to sing as Michael Jackson? I just blew my mind.
You know, it's one thing to be in the studio with effects on your voice and music and all that, but to just a cappella imitate somebody who's sitting across from you in a room full of strangers. You know, I've never even met the cast. And literally, everybody turns. You could hear everyone shifting in their seats, turning and looking at this dude, like, okay, let's see what you got, you know? It was really strange. I mean, luckily, I was a veteran by then of a million sessions, and so this was just one session of a million, you know? So it wasn't like I was thinking, oh my God, my whole career depends on this. I started singing, and I sang whatever it was, and everybody burst into applause, everybody's laughing, and he's smiling.
And I leaned over and said to Yardley, although I have no basis in fact for this supposition, but this may be a time to verify it, I said, we've paid just enough for the speaking Michael Jackson, but we can't afford the singing Michael Jackson.
It was a legal thing he couldn't
do? I believe so. That's what we heard, that his label said, I don't know, it sounds like a bunch of hooey to me, but for whatever reason.
No, I tried to find out what the story was, and he just said, I'm playing a joke on my brothers. That was what he said.
Really?
Nobody really knows the reason. I never knew the real reason why he didn't sing. He was definitely an artist, so he didn't want to release anything with his voice on it that hadn't been, you know, combed over a million times and worked on and overdubbed and fixed. And, you know, it took him a long time to release things because he wanted them to be right. So I would think, as a recording artist, he wouldn't want to release anything that's just done on the fly like that. So, you know, with his reputation on the line.
And then he worked with, he worked on Do the Bartman.
What do you mean? Oh, the song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so he worked quite closely with Nancy on that.
Michael produced Do the Bartman. And he was a huge Bart Simpson fan, just not just Simpsons, but Bart. He loved Bart. And I found this out, and I got the doll. I had another Kmart or somebody, I think it was, no, Toys R Us, was having a sale of these Bart dolls, because like I said, it was a prototype. Anyway, I went and I saw they were on sale for like 10 bucks each, so I bought a bunch, like it filled up my garage with these talking Bart dolls. So I signed it and I brought it with me, and Jim Brooks was there, and then Michael came out, and I had this doll behind my back, and I said, and he says, Michael, this is Nancy Cartwright, she's the voice of Bart. He's like, oh, I'm such a fan of Bart, oh, so nice to meet you. And I said, yeah, I brought you a little something, Michael, I heard you like Bart. He goes, oh, he loved it. He just thought it was the sweetest thing, and I had signed it, and we went in the studio, and he directed me, and that was really, really fun. We had, he's so low-key and so easygoing, and I remember, if you can do the Bart, you're bad like Michael Jackson. Just a little bit of a, for Michael. Oh, that was cool.